Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. And as you know, these days we are following the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 19 for our valuable viewers. So in today's lecture, we will start from building block number 4. In the previous lecture, which is lecture number 18, we have started this building block and we have seen the design structure and algorithm for the isothermal design. And now for the first part, we will move to the batch reactors, and accordingly we will do some batch reaction time calculations. So as we know that for the batch reactor, we assume or we say that there is no inflow or outflow of material and the reactor is well mixed. We have studied the properties in chapter number 1, which was of mole balance, building block number 1, that while deriving the equations, we have said that there is no flow in, no flow out, no special variations. For most liquid phase reactions, the density change with reaction is usually small, and accordingly we can say that capital V, which is volume, is equal to the initial volume is equal to the final volume. Accordingly, for gas phase reaction in which the batch reactor volume remains constant, we can also say it as V is equal to V naught. So we have studied all these aspects previously, but this slide is just a reminder of all that aspects. Now we want to calculate the batch reaction time. The system which we have been given is that 2 moles of A reacts to produce 1 mole of B and 1 mole of C. So accordingly we will go step by step. The first step is the mole balance. Since it's a batch reactor, so we will say NA naught dx over dt is equal to minus RA into V naught. And accordingly, once we rearrange it, dx over dt minus RA V naught over NA naught, and then V naught over NA naught will be 1 over CA naught. So accordingly, this NA naught over V naught will be CA naught, and accordingly it will appear over here. Then the second step is the rate law. Accordingly, the rate law will be minus RA is equal to KCA square, because we say that it is an elementary system and irreversible system. So accordingly, the equation will be written like that. Then going to the stoichiometry. And since we have said that V is equal to V naught, there is no epsilon, there is no pressure term, there is no temperature term, if you remember our previous lecture on stoichiometry. So accordingly, CA will be equal to CA naught into 1 minus X. So now once we have done step 1, which is mole balance, rate law, stoichiometry, the fourth step is to combine these three. And how we can combine it? By putting the value of CA over here. So accordingly, minus RA is equal to K CA naught square into 1 minus X whole square, and then substituting the minus RA value over here, and accordingly it will be dx over dt k CA naught square 1 minus x whole square in place of minus RA over CA naught. Now this CA naught will be cancelled out with this CA naught, and once we go to the evaluation part, how it will be done, dx over 1 minus x whole square, dt will go to this side, so it will be k2. We have represented it as k2 because it is a second order system. For first order system, we will say it as K1. So K2 CA naught dt. Then evaluating it by integration, K2 CA naught integral 0 to t dt is equal to integral 0 to x dx over 1 minus x whole square. And accordingly, that t of r, which is the reaction time, is equal to that K2 CA naught will go here, 1 over K2 CA naught, and this will be solved as x over 1 minus x. So this is the reaction time formula to calculate the batch reaction time for the second order system. In the same guidelines, or using the same guidelines, we can proceed for the first order system. How? Let's see it. Let's assume that 2A in an irreversible manner goes to B plus C. Accordingly, mole balance will be dx over dtr is equal to minus RA over CA naught. That will be same. For first order, the rate law will be minus RA is equal to KCA. For second order, it will be minus RA is equal to KCA square. For stoichiometry, it will remain the same. CA is equal to NA over V naught, and accordingly it is CA naught into 1 minus X. So for second order, we have already seen that equation. For first order, it will simply be K1 into 1 minus X, because CA is equal to CA naught into 1 minus X, and accordingly that CA naught will be cancelled out, so it will be K1 into 1 minus X. Then we have seen here TR is equal to 1 over K2 CA naught X over 1 minus X. Here you can see that it will be dx over 1 minus x. So its integral will be tr is equal to 1 over k1 natural log of 1 over 1 minus x. So it is simple mathematical calculations involved and how to solve the integral values. So K1 represents the rate constant for the first order reaction, K2 represents the rate constant for the second order reaction, and as you can see that in second order system that C0 term has come. So accordingly, if you go to third order, that will be C0 square. If you go to the fourth order, it will be C0 cube. And accordingly, you can see that how we can calculate the correlations for first order, second order systems. Now, let's assume that we have been given x is equal to 0.9 for both cases. K1 is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 4 per second, while K2 C0 is 10 raised to the power minus 3 per second. So let's solve one by one that T of R is equal to 1 over K1 natural log of 1 over 1 minus x. Now x is 0.9, K1 is 10 raised to the power minus 4. And accordingly, the T of R is equal to 23,000 seconds or 6.4 hours. While going here, TR is equal to 1 over K2 C0 x over 1 minus x. This K2 C0 is 10 raised to the power minus 3. X is 0.9, here it is also 0.9. So accordingly, we're substituting the values, and we get 9000 seconds or 2.5 hours. It means that with the increase in orders of reaction, the batch reaction time decreases in the system. And finally, the last slide for today, that how to calculate the total cycle time, because it is not only the reaction time, there are other times which must have been considered. Number one is the time required to fill that reactor, time required to heat the reactor together with the time required to clean the reactor. So feeding, heating represented by E, reaction R, and C is the cleaning. So these all times combine to form one total batch cycle time. Accordingly, you can see that in the book there are different reaction times given for the system, like for charge feed to the reactor and agitate, T of F is between 0.5 to 2 hours. Heat to reaction temperature, T of E 0.5 to 2 hours. Carry out reaction, again it will depend on the system, so it is a variable which varies from system to system. And empty and clean reactor, T of C 1.5 to 3 hours. And once we calculate all these, excluding obviously the reaction time because it will depend on the nature of the system, so 2.5 to 7 hours are required for feed, for heating, and for cleaning. And that does not include the reaction time. So if the reaction time is, for example, 10 hours, then you can see that it will be 12.5 to 17 hours, or maybe different case for the different system. And accordingly, you can see the batch reaction times for the first order, second order. Now you can see that the for first order, it is 10 raised to the power minus 4, and 10 raised to the power minus 3 means it is in hour. Then minutes, seconds, and it could be milliseconds. So as the K1 or K2 C0 values are increasing, the reaction time is decreasing. And it is obviously, if you go back to the previous relationships, you can see here that these are inverse of each other. So with the increase in K1, the value of reaction time decreases. The increase in K2 C0 value, the value of reaction time will decrease. So I hope you have understood the lecture. It was again an introductory lecture for batch reactor. In the next lecture, we will solve a comprehensive numerical for the batch reactor design. So I hope you have liked the video. If you have any queries, you can provide your comments, suggestions in the comment box, and I would be happy to answer these. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.